off London on the Beats. That's what I go by. And yeah, so you can tell by the title that I'm coming here to review Queen Naija's album. It is an R&B and soul album. It came out a couple of days ago, and I wanted to do a review on it. I didn't really have any expectations as far as like, oh, I think it's gonna be bad or I think it's gonna be good. Like, I didn't really have any. So I'm gonna go down the track list. It is 18 songs, and I got my AirPod in because I don't want to get copyrighted. And feel free to comment below what you think, what's your favorite songs, what songs you don't really like. It could be songs that you relate to. Yeah, because I mean, a song could be your favorite song, but you might not have been through that. But yeah, so I'll start with the intro. The intro was basically a lot of people saying comments and stuff about her, and the name of the title was called Misunderstood. So I feel like the intro was good to have like all those comments on there. The only thing I could say about that is like, I know that it was acting, but some of them just sound so fake. Like, they wasn't like putting feeling into it. But other than that, I feel like that was a good intro, especially because the album is called Misunderstood. And so then track number two is Too Much to Say. I really love the beat, and sometimes, well, I would say most of the time, I'm the type of person that in order for me to listen to the song, I gotta like the beat first, and then after that I'm gonna listen to the words and see if I like it. Too Much to Say, I really did like that beat. Let me try to sit up straight, y'all. I really did like that beat or whatever, and I did like what she was saying though. Like, she was saying how she got two kids and she can't stop, you know, and she just saying she got a lot of stuff to say, basically like, y'all not gonna shut up. I did like that. And so I was thinking about putting like a snippet of the songs, but like I said, I don't want to get copyrighted, so I'm not gonna do that. Then the next song, number two, is called I'm Her. Of course, my ladies, I know y'all gonna like that song because it just seemed like I'm her, like I'm that bitch, like don't play with me. Like, she said, I know you miss it, and you called my phone. Like, basically, stop playing with her. You, I'm that bitch, and you already know that. And she's featuring somebody named Kiana Lade. I never heard of that person. Y'all might have heard of that person, but anyway, I do like that song. And then my favorite two songs is number four, Pack Light. Oh my god, that's my favorite song. And it's so crazy because at first I didn't like it, but at first I wasn't like really listening to it. And so then I just started watching the video, and then I'm like, okay, I like this song. Because it's just like, Pack Light. Like, don't play with me. Like, I do all this shit for you, and I'm working hard to do what I gotta do for myself, and I'm working hard for this relationship. Pack Light. Keep the fuck moving. You give me bad vibes. If you don't get your act together, what you're going to have to do? Pack Light. Period. And then next song. Now, that's my number one song. Lie to Me featuring Lil Durk. First of all, I am from Chicago, so, and I love Lil Durk. And one thing about Chicago people, we rep our city, and we take up, and we support our big celebrities. That's one thing I can say about that. Now, as far as like, smaller people, I don't really know about that, but we do the big people. And so I did not really even like this song. I was just like, okay, whatever. But then I liked the video. because I feel like she was super cute. You know, like the video, the way it was put together and stuff like that, her outfits and everything, I feel like it was cute. And so I kept wanting to watch the video and not really listen to the song. But then of course I'm constantly liking the video and seeing the visuals. Then I started liking the song, and now I love this song. I listened to this song and Pack Lie to Me and Pack Light every day. Now I'm gonna show y'all, I'm gonna give y'all a snippet of this song because it's my favorite song, and I hopefully I don't get copyrighted because I was listening to it in my AirPod. That's my part. Hopefully you don't get copyrighted, y'all. That's my favorite song. He funny as hell. Something about ain't nobody credit. He tried to buy her ass with Obamacare. He disrespectful. He trying to fuck even though her mama there. Like, y'all know how that goes sometimes. Okay, and so then the next song, number 6, is called Dream featuring Lucky Day. Again, I don't know who that is. I do like this song. I feel like it's a song where you can just like be vibing with your man, like just on some chill shit. I do like it. I like the beat too, so I really do like that song. And then of course, like, if you in love, like, it seems like when you are in love, love songs like hit different than when you're not in love or when you're not in a relationship. But I do like that song. And the next song is number 7, is called Love Language. She has a video out for that, and so when the video first came out, I like played the song, and then I was like, I ain't never like really finished it because I didn't really want to listen to it. But I did end up listening to it, and I actually do like it because she just was talking about like what she want her man to do. And she's like basically saying like, you need to love me in my love languages. Like, we all have different love languages. And I encourage you, whether you're single or you're not, I encourage you to take the love language test. You can Google it. And especially if you are in a relationship, I encourage you and your partner to take the love language test, because we have to realize that we can't love. We cannot keep loving our partners in our love language because we might not speak the same love language. So my significant other, his love language could be words of affirmation, but my love language could be small little gifts. So if I'm giving him a small little gift, and I'm thinking like, oh, this is how I'm showing you that I love you, he don't really care for it, we don't really know if he feel loved or not. You get what I'm saying? Like, our love languages could be the same, could be different. But we just gotta kind of remember, like, to love each other in our love language. And she was basically saying, like, oh, like, you know, like, you need to pay attention to me. You need to do this, you need to do this. This is my love language. You need to, love me in my love language. And so, I definitely get that. Hold on, because I'm trying to go to the next one. Okay. This number keep calling me. So honestly, I'm trying to figure out what's going on. Anyway. Okay, so the next one is called, this is number 8. Called Without You featuring Russ. It gives me like Lauryn Hill 90s vibes. I mean, I like the song. It's basically saying like, I'll try to go to a lyric. Basically saying like, what would I do without you? Sad thing is I probably wouldn't know how to live without you. And she just basically saying like, how comfortable she feel with this person, and so they in tune with each other, and basically like, she don't know what she would do if she didn't have this person, because this person make her feel so free or whatever. So I like it. It's not a bad song. And number 9 is Say What You Mean. And of course my lady's probably gonna like this song, because it's like, what's up with the back and forth? Like, we arguing and you saying all this stuff, but then after we good, you don't really mean it. So it's just like, say what you mean and basically mean what you say. Like, if you say you don't want to be with me, then keep it moving. Don't try to come back to me, or like, just don't be saying stuff because you mad at me. Like, you get what I'm saying? Like, so I feel like it's a decent song or whatever. I do like the beat. It's just like, even though at a young age, like, I'm like 25, I'm gonna be 26. I'm not old or nothing like that, but I've been through stuff in past relationships where it's just like, you're arguing with somebody and you say some shit that you don't even mean. But she just saying like, don't say what you mean what you say. Don't say you don't want to be with me and you really do. Because she just saying like, that's not the type of relationship that she want to be in. She want to, yeah, people have disagreements, but like, I don't know. Some people, when they get me, they be saying a lot of shit. And so she just saying like, if you want to, you know what I'm saying, if you don't want to be with me, just let me know. She was just talking about how like, she been through some stuff before. Excuse me if y'all hear my dog. He's crying because he wants to go upstairs, and right now he cannot go upstairs because I'm not up there. So anyway, basically she just saying that she been through a lot of stuff and you don't gotta lie to her. She can handle it. Mean what you say and say what you mean, period. So then the next one is just a little skit. It's called Bitter Skit, because after it, it's the song called Better. The skit was funny with Pretty V. And so then at 11 is the actual song Better. That comes after the skit featuring Mulatto. I really like her. She really can rap. And I just love women who can say whatever they want to say and don't worry about what nobody else think. I love women like that. I feel like they're very like empowering to women and encouraging to them. So Bitter, I mean, I like it, but I don't like it as much as the other songs. So I feel like, but I'm the type of person that the songs have to keep growing on me. I gotta keep listening to them, and then I start liking them. Just like I said, when I started listening to a lot of me, I ain't really like it like that, but then I kept on like playing in and stuff like that, and so then I liked it. But Bitter, it could be the beat that I don't really too much like. Then the next one is called One Time featuring Tusi. And I like the beat. I'm just trying to go to the lyrics. Right now I don't really too much care for it. Like, when I was listening to it, like, I listen to her album over and over because I want to really see if I like the songs, and I wanted to like be able to review this stuff for my YouTube page. But I end up turning from the song because I'm just like, okay, whatever. I don't even keep listening to it. The next song is number 13 is Pressure. I'm just trying to see, like, right now it's playing in my ear. Like, I let the beginning play so I can, like, kind of get a refreshing of the song. I don't too much care for this song either. She basically just talking about, like, how she feel like it's something going on. Even if he say it's not something going on, he just feel like something is up. Y'all, hold on, this is my boyfriend. Okay, y'all. Oh, wait. No, I need to. Okay, y'all, I'm back in my bed. My boyfriend called me. Anyway, I think the last thing I was talking about was Pressure. Yeah. I don't really too much care for that song at all. 5 Seconds with Jacquees. This song a lot, actually. I really like the beat, and I think I ended up liking it because, like, she kind of did like a little snippet of this song on her YouTube page. I like this song a lot, actually. I'm about to go to the lyrics. I'm sorry. She basically just talking about like, okay, yeah, I be seeing. Like, I'm gonna leave you. I'm walking out the door. And, I said I was gonna leave and I still stayed. But she just saying, like, she's tired of, you know, going through the ups and downs with this person. Like, bye. See you. And then she just saying, like, this your last time. I done gave you so many chances. I kept on saying I was gonna do this and I did never do it. But now, I'm done. I do like that song though a lot. I really like the beat, actually. And that was number 14. Number 15 is Pretend. I like that song too. Like, don't pretend with me. Like, just keep it 100. Keep it real. Like, I know a lot of people can relate to that. Whether you a man or a woman, like, you can relate to that. When you, like, it's not even just about, like, being in a relationship. It's friends, family, and significant others, or potential significant others. Like, you don't really know who really there for you, or they see that they can benefit from you, or benefit from being around you, so they just want to be there and but not really be there for you. They want to be there for basically the benefit. So she's just saying, like, don't pretend with me. Keep it real. I really like that song a lot. And I could definitely relate to that. Number 16 is called Trial and Error. I'm letting it play out right now because, like I said, I gotta remember, like, I mean, the song not bad, but like I said, like, certain songs just have to grow on me, but for right now, I feel like it's a decent, it's not a bad song. I just don't like it myself right now. But it's not a bad song at all. It's just a song about seeing, telling people, like, she's just because she in the light, she's human and she can make mistakes. And she just, you know, she's a human, basically. And then number 17 is Butterflies Part 2. I like this song. It's nothing I can really say about this song because everybody already heard Butterflies, the first one, when she made her first EP. And it's just like, she was just talking about how he made her feel. And she just basically saying, like, damn, you still make me feel this way. Or even better. So, like, of course I like that song. And then her last song is number 18 and it's called Beautiful. Again, let's go to some lyrics. I like this song too, but honestly, like, when I was driving and listening to this song, it was making me sleepy. But it's just because it's just so slow and melodic. So, but like nothing bad. Like overall, how I feel about her album, I really think that she has a good album. And 18 songs, and most of the songs I like them. She can really sing. The people she worked with was perfect. The beats that she got, it was perfect. It really did give you the 90s vibe. And then she had the visuals. This was super smart that she did this. She had the visuals on YouTube to her album, like 2-3 minute clips, and she called them episodes. And it was definitely giving Moesha vibes, like Dear Diary. I feel like that was a great idea to do that. Then my camera is really getting on my nerves. It's like not even my camera, it's my memory card, and it's a brand new memory card, and it steady be saying error sometimes, like I need to format it. No, I'm not, because I'm not gonna lose all my footage. So hopefully I didn't lose all my footage. But anyway, like I was saying before, I had cut me messed up my stuff though. But I feel like those hoodies was $50. I feel like that's way too much. And then the Misunderstood Diary got like 160 pages in there. It's like $20. I feel like that's reasonable. But the other merch and the shirts and stuff, I feel like that cost too much. But overall, I feel like this album was really good. And I hope that people who doubted her, I hope that she shut them up. Because there was a lot of people talking about how, oh, she can't be a YouTuber and be an R&B singer or whatever like that. And I just feel like, why not? Why can't she do both? Like, we as fans want to see her life as well. Like, we watch other people who are not quote unquote celebrities. They're YouTube celebrities. So they a random person that we found off YouTube. Why not? Like, you know what I'm saying? Why not want to be into a big Hollywood celebrity's life or whatever and see like behind the scenes? So, like I said, overall, I feel like the album was really good. It was a lot of songs on there, but a lot of songs that I liked. And I just hope the best for her. I hope you guys like this video. I hope you guys like this review. Make sure you comment. Make sure you share. Make sure you like. Make sure you subscribe. And please, please, please leave a comment down and let me know, what was your favorite song? What was your least favorite song and why? And I see y'all in my next video. Y'all might see me with this same outfit on because I'm probably going to do another video. I'm just trying to knock these videos out and I'm trying to stay consistent. So, see y'all later. Bye.